Okay, so to come to Cabin in the Woods, just firstly, can you tell us about the origin of the film?
Yeah, it started in my brain, and not in any way that I can remember. It was just, one day it was just there. It's sort of the logical extension of what I think about horror movies, and it's sort of, the whole film just sort of fell in. And but it's, I mean, I spent a lot of time, and particularly then when I was doing Buffy, dealing with the genre, and you know, I love it very much, and so it doesn't really surprise me that it came. It surprised me how quickly.
There seems to be a bit of an Evil Dead vibe to it.
Yes, absolutely.
Was that one of the big influences, and have you shown it to Sam Raimi and Bruce Campbell yet?
No, actually, we haven't shown it to, well, we haven't shown it to anyone. It was put on a shelf, or in a vault somewhere. But Peter Deming actually shot Evil Dead 2, our DP, and both Rue and I are huge fans, although I have to say, for the record, Evil Dead 1 is really the classic. Evil Dead 2 is fine, it's very good, but Evil Dead 1 is really the treasure.
There's a few people in our office who would argue with you all day about that.
Oh yeah, oh I know.
Could you tell us, have you ever had a holiday staying somewhere creepy?
I've definitely, gone off. I've definitely gone into the woods with a group of people. I'd actually, in college, went off to have a party in the woods with some friends, and on the way there, I realized, oh God, we're the cast of a horror movie. I mean, we've got the slutty girl, we've got this, we've got that, and I'm the annoying guy who I'm gonna die like second, I think. And the guy's like, you guys aren't trying to ditch me, are you? Where is everybody? I'm that guy. That was a little scary. We had a farm in upstate New York, which at night, the nearest neighbor was about 3 miles away. And my love of gothic, sort of American gothic horror is probably rooted a bit in that as well.
So apart from creepy woods, is there anything else that scares you, gives you cold sweats?
Scares me, particularly? Enormous bugs. Not a fan of enormous bugs. Also everything.
A bit of a cross-franchise question here. Which of the Avengers would make it to the end of Cabin in the Woods, or would get the furthest?
Gosh, well, one would seem to want to answer Thor. Ultimately, the Hulk. Because Banner could figure everything out, and then the Hulk could work his way through it.
Smash puny cabin.
Smash puny cabin.
The Hulk was one of the Avengers that didn't get on the cover. Can you tell us how far is the Hulk finished now?
He's not quite finished. It's been the hardest and most deliberate process is to create every moment of the Hulk, because we're animating, we're creating him from whole cloth at the same time as we've got all this reference from Mark. We're trying to stay true to Mark and his physicality, as well as creating something that is completely beyond human physicality, and making sure that he, looks and feels like a real member of the team, a real character, and not a great big CG blob. And that the specificity of not just his actions, but his expressions from moment to moment, so that, he's not just roaring, At some point I did have to explain, he's not a Tyrannosaurus Rex. He's not just gonna roar all the time. Sometimes he's just gonna be pissed off about something. And trying to figure out what it is from moment to moment and how that would be expressed is extraordinarily difficult. But I think that we are succeeding.